Oh, these are interesting books.
Mom, I want some candy. Okay, well, I'm trying to talk to Christian right now. So
that
Mom, I want to go to Dairy Queen.
Can you write your name down, ma'am?
I'm hungry,
so sorry.
Mom. Don't, I just bought you books, so you'll behave or you can go to the car.
And if you want a discount...
No, I didn't actually mean it.
If you want a discount, you could write that down. And that would be $5 in total, man.
I lost my money.
Oh, it's okay.
Here you go.
Oh, thank you. Oh, you forgot your books too.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Should we do that?
The skit you just saw shows how people who are perceived as being from America are treated. Now you will see how different people of color are treated.
I'd like to purchase these books. Oh, they're nice.
Mommy, more books.
You could sign your name down right here, ma'am. How much are the books? They're $50, ma'am.
They're too expensive, I'm sorry. They got a discount while we don't get a discount.
I'm sorry, you don't get a discount. There's no such thing.
They people, we people, we get discount too.
You're not gonna get a discount. I'm sorry. Either leave or buy the books.
Mommy!
Let's just go.
Mommy! Girls, Inc. And today we'll be doing an interview with my friend from Girls, Inc. What are your thoughts of xenophobia?
So, well, first of all, let me clarify that xenophobia is a fear of immigrants. And my thoughts on xenophobia is that it doesn't need to exist because it's just really unnecessary and it's a waste of time. On top of that, I myself am an immigrant, so I've experienced some of these things, and I can just tell you that it's not fun to experience, and we don't need it.
Why do you think xenophobia exists?
Well, there's a famous quote by Andrew Smith, and it says that people fear what they don't understand and hate they can't conquer, and I think that kind of just explains what xenophobia, why xenophobia exists, because, you know, like, immigrants haven't been around for like that long, but you know, like if you're from here, you don't really, if you have a lack of education around you, you don't understand what other people's cultures are and other people's daily days are, so you don't really get to understand or experience the culture all over you, so yeah.
Can you tell me about how you got here?
I am from Ethiopia, and I have a family of five, me, my mom and dad, my little brother who's 10 months old, and my other brother who's 10 years old in fifth grade, and we came, I think it was 2008, and it was on a DV lottery, so what you do is that you put your name into like this bucket, and it's totally random, so like someone pulls out one like card, and who's ever name is on that card gets to go to America. And my family was super lucky because it's really unlikely that you'll get it, but if you do, it's just like, whoa. And I came here when I was 3 years old. My brother that's in fifth grade came here when he was 8 months old. So you could say that he was born here, basically. He just grew up here. And my smallest one, the 10-month-old one, was just born a year ago.
Thank you for talking with us today.
Thanks.
I think it's a waste of time to be racist. I think it's not something we need in the world. So what are your thoughts on racism?
I think that there shouldn't be racism in the world because it makes people feel, put them down.
Why do you think people are racist?
I think because they're scared and they want to put down what's different from them. What do you think? Why do you think people are racist?
Because some people want other people to feel bad because They feel bad about themselves and some people are against other people's race.
How do you think we could stop racism?
You can stand up for someone that someone else is picking on them because of their race. How do you think we can stop racism?
One, not be racist, and two, stand up to the people who are being racist. Don't be a bystander.
What is your family's traditions?
One of my family's traditions are going to pray, then going to IHOP for Eid. Then we go anywhere else. What's your family's tradition?
Mostly me and my grandma and my grandpa would go clothes shopping for Eid, go to prayer, and then we would go stop at my cousin's house to pick them up, and then we'd meet up in my cousin's house, my house, or my grandma's house, and then we have a huge party afterwards, and yeah.
Okay, so what is the difference of my Eid and your Eid?
Your parents get, how much days off was it?
Like the last day or 2 days.
2 days off. My parents have 2 weeks off to help us. So that's something different.